In this vlog, we will try to see the concept of Flutter Firebase Authentication. So by making use of Firebase, we are integrating login functionality in our Flutter application. If you are new to this particular concept, I suggest you to go through our previous tutorials on Firebase in our channel, and there you can understand how we need to configure Firebase into our Flutter applications. So I have also explained in detail regarding iOS applications. Some of you might have been getting issues while configuring the Firebase into your iOS application using Flutter. So now let's get started with this particular tutorial. So the first thing we need to add is dependencies here. So open the pubspec file and try to add these two particular dependencies, like Firebase Authentication and Firebase Core. So these are the current versions I'm specifying here, and please try to update the latest versions when you are trying this particular tutorial. And now tap on this particular button, pubget, so that our dependencies will be successfully configured with our application. And once you see this particular message, we can get started with our coding. Let's try to import material.dart here, and also we require few imports regarding Firebase, which we will be doing when required. And also I suggest you to follow this particular tutorial till the end, because sometimes you may not be able to know the exact error. Follow this tutorial and you can avoid your issues and can easily integrate Firebase Authentication into your applications. So now let's declare our void main, which is an asynchronous method here. So we are making use of future, and here we will try to initialize our Firebase. So widgets Flutter binding dot ensure initialize, and we need to await till our Firebase is initialized. You need to import Firebase code dot dot here, and now here we are specifying run app as usual, and here you can just specify my app and try to declare a stateless widget my app, and here we will be returning a material app, and inside which we will going to declare scaffold, and inside the scaffold we will be providing an app bar. So these are all the general things, but as we are targeting a beginner, so I'm just explaining each and everything. And specify body now. So inside the body, I'm going to consider one more class, and I will be specifying it like app, and let's try to declare a stateful widget with the name app here. Let us consider two variables of type boolean, initialized equal to false, and one more variable false. Specify a method void Flutter Firebase Fire. So what is Flutter Firebase Fire? Here you can see Flutter Fire is the official Firebase plugins for Flutter applications. So here we are making use of the same for our method name, and this is again of a type asynchronous. Why? Because here we are trying to initialize our Firebase application, and also specify try catch to avoid any issues. Here we need to specify await. So this particular step, most of you might have been facing some issues, so follow this particular step carefully. And here Firebase dot initialize app, and now we'll try to set state. As we are using a stateful widget, specify initialize equal to true, which is the boolean variable which we have declared earlier. And inside the catch, let's make use of this set state and try to set the error to true here. Let's try to format the code and also specify an init state here, and inside which try to call this particular method Flutter Firebase Fire. Instead of return container here, I'm going to return a particular method initialize, and let's try to create the same here. So what we'll be doing in this particular method initialized is, I'm going to return a text button. So whenever our Firebase is successfully initialized in our Flutter application, I'm going to return a text button which will be having two prerequisites like onPress and child, a text widget which will be helpful for us to display a message like signup. And inside the onPress, we will be trying to specify the signup procedure here. And now, before getting any further, we need to configure our Firebase console so that we will be getting required JSON file and plist file for both our Android and iOS applications. Let's get ahead to our Firebase console here, as I have already created Android application and iOS application. So you can just go through our previous tutorials where I have shown you how we can create these two applications here. So now let's go to our Android application, and here you can find the Google services JSON file. You need to download this particular file, and also for iOS you are having info.plist file here. So getting back to our Android studio, inside the Android folder, so inside the app directory, you need to specify the Google services JSON file here. I suggest you to follow this particular exact location so that you will not face any issues. And if you have provided the JSON file anywhere else, the compiler might not detect it. And also there are few more things you need to take care of before getting Firebase authentication with your Android application, especially here. So you need to go through this particular build.gradle file here, follow this particular path here exactly, and make sure you are specified Google here inside repositories. If it is already specified, no problem. And here, try to add this particular class path here. It will not be specified by default. You need to add this particular class path here under the dependencies. And also inside the all projects, you need to specify Google here. If already specified, then you can skip it. And now move to this particular build.gradle file under your app directory, and there you need to apply the plugin. You need to apply the plugin Google services, and now you are good to go with your Android application. And for iOS application, I have clearly explained the Firebase configuration to add Firebase to your iOS application in this particular video, and I have provided the link in the description section below also. You may go through it and add your plist file accordingly. So now let's get back to our code here. And one more thing here, inside the Firebase console, you are having authentication section here. So if you are opening this particular authentication for the first time, you might be seeing a button called get started. So tap on that particular button and you will be redirected to this particular screen here. So currently I have enabled email by password here. So this particular provider I have enabled, and the remaining things I have not enabled still. And in our coming tutorials, we will try to see how we can make use of a Google and several other email providers and log into our application by making use of this Firebase authentication. If you want to add new providers, you can just tap on the add new provider here. And currently, as I have specified, I have only enabled email password here. And you can also make use of the phone number and all these additional providers. So in our coming tutorials, I will be trying to integrate few of them. And if you are having any queries in this particular topic, do let me know in the comment section below. So now let's get back here. So inside the users, if you want to add the user from the console level, you can just specify the email ID and password here and tap on the add user button here. So in this way, we have added this particular email address now. And let's try to delete these things. And also make sure that if you try to delete the email ID, then you cannot log in with this particular email ID again until or unless you sign up. That is, you again registered with the same email ID, then you can log in again. So now we are currently having no users for this project. So now let's try to add users to our project here. So whenever you have configured this particular JSON file and plist file, your app gets configured to the Firebase and you can interact with the Firebase with your Flutter application. And now let's try to provide the on-press functionality here. And also we need to have few more things here. So we have specified two boolean variables like initialized and error, and also based upon the initialization process we have set them to true here. So if there is any error here, so you need to return. Let's try to create two more methods here like error handling, error handle, and inside which you can return a text widget where you can see there is an error. And let's try to create one more widget here. So this one more widget will handle the progress bar. So if not initialized, till then you need to specify this particular widget where you can provide a progress bar here. So currently here also I am specifying. Okay, you can just specify your progress bar over there. And now let's specify them here. So return progress handle and return error handle. Also you can specify your declarations here itself, but I just want to make it much clearer. So we have divided everything. Just add the curly braces. So now let's provide our Firebase signup procedure here. So this is the particular documentation file here, and I will be providing the link also in the description section below. And also I will be providing the entire code link also in the description section below. I suggest you to go through that particular link if you are having any queries in writing the code. And now let's try to copy this particular code here. So this is a registration section, and later we have sign in section also. So for now let's get with this registration part. And inside the text button I am providing this particular block of code and try to import this Firebase authentication. And also as this is requesting for an await, you need to provide asynchronous here. So make sure you provide asynchronous for this corresponding text button. And yes, now we are good to go here. So what we are trying to do here is we are trying to add a particular email. So now let's provide your name here. Actually this is not my email ID, so I'm just trying to specify anything over here. And inside the password, let's specify something like anything you can specify over here. Let's try to run this particular code and see the output and see whether our user is added or not. And here you can see currently we have deleted all our users, and try to refresh it and we are not having any users currently. So now let's try to run in Android device for the first time, and later we'll try to run in iOS device. So if you are having any queries in this particular implementation, feel free to let me know in the comment section below. If you are trying to implement any other specific functionality regarding the Firebase, Flutter, so let me know. I will try to help you if possible. And here you can see we have got our sign up button here which we have specified. And now try to tap on this particular sign up button. And here now let's try to check in this particular section whether our user is. Yes, here you can see our user email ID is now added. So on October 13th. So just now we have added this particular user here. So instead of providing these static values here, let's specify text field here and for username and user password, we are going to specify two text fields here. And inside these fields, let's provide a controller. So the controller is like username controller, and for the password, password controller. And now let's declare them here. So username controller equal to text editing controller, and one more is for password controller. So text editing controller. Okay. So now let's make use of these two controllers and fetch the email ID text dot to string, and the same here password controller dot text dot to string. And now let's try to run this particular code and see the output. And let's try to make them to the center so that it looks much better, and also to the column. Let's try to add some padding, like 20 I'm going to add. So let's try to provide some email address here, api@email.com, and password to be abhi. So now let's try to tap on this particular sign up button here. So here you can see we have got a message that the password you have provided is too weak. And yes, we have provided a very weak password. So let's try to provide some number with it and try to tap on the sign up button. And now here you can see we have added one more email here. So in this way you can just try to add any number of emails. So in this way you can just configure your Firebase authentication with the Android application we have seen. And now let's try to see the same with our iOS application. So try to run the code in our iOS application as well. So here you can see we have got the exact output like our Android application. And here let's try to provide the same thing like, and now let's try to tap on this particular sign up button here, and let's go back to our authentication section and see whether our email ID is added or not. So here you can see this particular email we have tried to add from our iOS device, and this one is from our Android device here. So now I think you understood how we can add this sign up, that is registration process, based on Firebase into our Flutter application. So in our coming tutorials we also try to see how we will make a sign in. So sign up is a bit complicated and we have done through it, and sign in is a bit easier when compared to the sign up process. And in our coming tutorials we also try to see few more providers like Facebook, Google, Twitter, and see how we can make use of these particular accounts and log into our Flutter application with the help of Firebase. And I will be providing the code for this particular tutorial in the description section below. And also do let me know your queries in the comment section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.